Hello, welcome back to Chess Vlog. So, this is not a saw-saw video like I usually do. Actually, this is a revisit of one of my few videos na hanggang ngayon may nanonood pa rin, which is regarding insurance or VUL. So, if heads up lang, this is not scripted, meaning I'm just extemporaneous to. So, meaning, if my thoughts sound disorganized, this is a rant. So my policy will be on its 6-year anniversary by January of 2024. So, specifically, hindi ko makita yung exact amount of its earnings. It's a VUL policy, and kasi nag-error, and I'll put the error here. I've been trying to check it on a weekly basis. Wala lang, parang just to monitor my AXA policy, pero hindi ko talaga makita. So, there might be a system-wide issue why it's happening, so might be in the coming weeks, it might be okay. So, if you are also an AXA policy holder, let me know if nakikita mo yung policy or yung earnings or yung interest ng VUL policy mo. Feel free to let me know sa app na yon, because for me, it hasn't been working this past several weeks. So I will make an estimate basing on the last data that I saw, which was almost like 3 months ago. So full disclosure, yung binabayad ko sa policy ko is around 2.5. It's not the super duper exact amount, basta yun yung range. I think the wrong way that most people compute how much your VUL policy is going to earn is like this. So ina-assume nila na 2.5 yung hulog nila, so 2.5 times, yan, for example, yung 6 years, which is 72 months. So, in their heads, i-compute nila is 2.5 times 72 months is equal to, they'll be expecting na 180,000 yung supposed na earnings ng policy nila. Which is, again, that is the incorrect way of assuming yung policy earnings mo, because hindi po siya how it works. So the best way to look at it is to go to your policy book or yung booklet. Pero I think ngayon yung mga bagong policies na ini-issued, puro mga PDF na lang. Kasi nga paperless, sure value. So may table yon, and then it will show you like the estimated earnings mo on the per year. I'll try to get one, pero otherwise, if wala, I'll just put a note how much it is here, yung estimated ha, and how much is the actual based on my dito na rin. So to be honest, it feels a little unsatisfactory. Eh, ganun talaga. And I am assuming that before watching this video, it's either may policy ka na, may VUL policy ka na, nag-i-inquire ka, or you are complaining na na-scam ka ng VUL. Because that's the common type of audience I get in my videos whenever I post this kind of topic. Maraming nagra-rant. May isa pa nga nagsabi na, ipapatulpo namin ang this so-and-so company. And I said, go ahead, magsama-sama pa kayo, tapos mag-collective complaint kayo kay Tulfo. I would love to see that happen. Panonoorin ko yun. Parang the Tulfo Brothers versus the Philippine Insurance Companies. I would love to see that. So far, I haven't seen anything of that happening. So what's my goal? Do I plan to keep this policy? Oo naman, kasi nga, di ba, parang I said, the wrong way to think about it is i-compute mo yung magkaning hinuhulog mo. Tapos, like, how many months have passed? That's the incorrect way. Because it doesn't work that way. Kasi you're also paying for the insurance aside from the supposed earnings. So, you are also paying for the benefits na kaakibat nung policy mo. Kasi nga, di ba, for example, yung face amount. Again, this is an example. Face amount mo, meaning pag na ano ka, this is the X amount of money that your beneficiary will get. Tapos may kasama yung critical illness na may asterisk pa yon up to a certain age na in case you get this kind of list of critical illnesses, you will be able to get this X amount. Siguro probably nilagay ko na rito yung sample na benefit nung policy. So again, I probably am thinking kasi I have the option to keep paying until the end of my 10th year tapos i-leave it alone and see what happens. And then I kaso nga lang ano eh, nakita ko yung the possibility yung sa table kasi yung table of earnings niya or parang yeah malaki yung maiaawas. So you can do that if it's available to your policy, mag-premium holiday ka on your 10th year. Tapos antayin mo na lang kung ano na yung magiging itsura niya by the time you're 60 years old. Or I might go with the ano, with the possibility of just ano, bayaran ko na lang, panindigan ko na until 60 or 65. Let's see what happens. Pero siguro tinanggap ko na rin ng malubog sa damdamin na it might not be as high as I wanted it to be. Pero malay natin kasi nga yung earnings, yung investment part ng VUL insurance kasi, that is subject to market forces. Pretty much like yung stock markets, yung ETF, UITF, ng mga bangko, it's all the same. Recap lang of what I ranted in this video. Number one, kaya maraming galit na feeling nila na scam sila ng VUL is because they thought or they were miscomputing or mali yung expectation nila of how much their earnings should be. That's always been the case in the comments. That's ganun yung madalas ko nakikita. Number two, on my 6th anniversary ng policy ko, I'm not particularly happy with its performance, but hodo. But anyways, ayun lang po. Comment section, bahala kayo dyan. Basta I will treat you the way you treat me. So, if bastos ka sa comment section, bastusan po tayo. So, yun lang po. Thank you for watching.